Greetings to all. Welcome to the official YouTube channel of SRN International School. I'm Pallavi Tandon, Faculty of English at SRN International School, situated in Jagatpura, Jaipur. Today, I will be telling you very precisely and in a very simplified manner the poem from grade 11th, Childhood. Childhood is written by Marcus Natal. In this poem, the poet thinks over his lost childhood. He wonders about the moment where he lost the innocence and realized that the world is not what he seemed it to be. He recalls when his thoughts changed and he realized the hypocrisy of the people around him. He finally settled down to the idea that his childhood went to some forgotten place and is hidden in the face of an innocent infant. Now let me tell you about the poet Marcus Natal. Marcus Duzak was born on 23 June 1975 and he was an Australian writer. He is best known for the book Thief and the Messenger, two novels which became international bestsellers. He won the Margaret A. Edwards Award in 2014. Duzak is the author of six books. His first three books, The Underdog, Fighting Reuben Wolf, and When Dogs Cry, released between 1999 and 2001. The Messenger, published in 2002, won the 2003 CBC Book of the Year Award and the 2003 NSW Premier's Literary Award in Australia and was a runner-up for the Prince Award in America. In 2014, Duzak won the Margaret A. Edwards Award from the American Library Association. The theme of the poem. Childhood comes up with the theme of childhood, hypocrisy, and egotism. A close look at each of these themes can provide a better understanding of the poem as a whole. The poem Childhood by Marcus Natal is about poet's reaction to his loss of childhood. The poet feels he lost his childhood when he became 12 years old. The second guess he makes is maybe he lost it when he could not find heaven and hell in his geography book. And maybe when he realized the hypocrisy of adults, or maybe when he realized his mind could think his own peculiar and unique thoughts. Finally, he concluded that he lost his childhood, which is hidden in an infant's face. Now, let us start with the paraphrasing. The lines here are, when did my childhood go? Was it the day I ceased to be 11? Was it the time I realized that hell and heaven could not be found in geography and therefore could not be? Was that the day? So here in the above lines, the poet wonders about when his childhood came to an end. He asked himself, was it the day he was no longer 11 years old? Was it the day when he realized that hell and heaven existed and yet could not be found in geography or on the map? It is something of imagination. He realized that they are imaginary places that actually do not exist in this world. Next paragraph, or this stanza says like this, that when did my childhood go? Was it the time I realized that adults were not as they seemed to be? They talked of love and preached of love, but did not act so lovingly. Was that the day? So he is simply asking the questions. He's trying to seek the answer for his query. Here in this stanza, the poet is highlighting the hypocritic approach of the adults. In this stanza, poet repeats the same question about when did his childhood go. He wonders about the day when he started seeing the world, when he started seeing the world with a new perception that adults are hypocrites and are not how they seem to be. The adults who talked of love and preached of love, yet never behaved so lovingly. They are double-faced. In reality, was that the day when his childhood go? Now, in this stanza, it says, when did my childhood go? Was it when I found my mind was really mine, to use whichever way I choose, producing thoughts that were not those of other people, but my own and mine alone? Was that the day? In this stanza, this is the third stanza of the poetry, the poet deliberates on the same question about when he lost his childhood. He asked himself about possibilities. He wonders about the day he realized that his mind was his own and could use it the way he wants. When he realized that he could produce his own thoughts, which were not bound by anyone, when he sensed his own individuality and a separate personality, was that the day he lost his childhood? And in this last stanza, the poet says, where did my childhood go? It went to some forgotten place. That's hidden in an infant's face. That's all I know. So here in this last stanza, the poet remorses about his lost childhood. He concludes that his childhood had gone to some forgotten place, which will never come back. He cherished his innocence, which vanished now and could only be seen in an infant's face or on the face of a baby. He only has sweet memories of his childhood, which would soon fade away. He also conveyed a message that the innocence of the childhood stays till the time one is infant, and that is all he knows. So somewhere he wants to reflect this thing that childhood can be said as the synonym of infant or innocence. Okay. Now let us move towards the literary device which is used in this poetry. The very first one is the rhyming scheme. The rhyme scheme used in the poem Childhood is ABBCCD. Then we have refrain, that is a group of phrase which is repeated in the poem. That is, you must have noticed that the line like, when did my childhood go? Was that the day? Has been repeated in these stanzas. Then you have individuality, like in stanza 3, the poet realized that he can use his own mind and can produce his own thoughts. We have seen that there is antithesis also, which is used where two opposite words are used together in a sentence that is in a poem, that is hell and heaven. We have alliteration as well. So alliteration is nothing else but the occurrence of the same letter of sound at the beginning of closely connected words, like the time, my mind, whichever way, thoughts that. So these are some of the literary device which is used in this piece of poetry. Now the conclusion. So here to conclude the poetry, we can say that this particular poem, Childhood, the poet discusses how the innocence of childhood gets lost as when one grows older and become aware about the realities of life. I hope, students, you must have understood this poem well. If you have liked this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.